Huma says, can a girl perform her salat late on her wedding as she is with makeup, or can she perform the salat with the makeup with tayammum? First of all, the scenario is as this. A woman has a wedding, whether she's a bride or she's a guest. They go to the hairdressers after Asr time, and they are in the state of wudu. They put on makeup, and usually it is expensive. It's not something that you can just simply wash off and put it again in 5 minutes. They usually take like half an hour to get themselves adorned in such a fashion. And then they pray Maghrib, and they go to the wedding. When it's Isha time, they've nullified, they broke their wudu. So what to do? Situation one, you have to remove the makeup and perform wudu, especially if the makeup is waterproof, water resistant. You have to wash your face. This is salat. This is something important. Yes, but Sheikh, I've paid $300, $500 to get these paints on my face. This is your problem. You have till midnight. After that, the prayer is invalid. And if you pray it after midnight, it would not be accepted because you deliberately skipped prayer on time. So what to do, Sheikh? You have another alternative. Such weddings usually take place, especially for a bride, once in a lifetime. Therefore, when you go to the hairdresser or to the salon and you get these makeups on you, first of all, make sure that you make wudu. So after you make or put these things on your face and you're already in the state of wudu, when you pray Maghrib, combine to it Isha. So you pray Maghrib 3 rak'ahs, and afterwards you pray Isha 4 rak'ahs, and after that, you don't have any problem with breaking your wudu because you have prayed Isha. But if you did not do this, and it's Isha time, and you have till midnight, then put Cinderella in your mind. When it's midnight, it's over. So you cannot perform tayammum because tayammum is not permissible to use except in the inability to use water. So, excuse me, are you unable to use water? She says, no, I can use water, but then I have to wash my... Khalas, you have to wash your face. But someone who is unable, either because there is no water or because he is medically prohibited from touching water, in this case, he can make tayammum, which is dry ablution.